Blackhead Chat. It's one of the most popular hacking chat rooms on the dark web. And today I'm walking you through how to create your own chat exactly like Blackhead Chat. It's fully customizable and friendly with Tor. And the coolest thing, it doesn't require JavaScript. This means you can publish it on the clearnet or even the dark web. So this is Emersik, go get your coffee ready and let's dive in. So first, if you don't know what Blackhead Chat is or you did not saw it before, so here, as you can see here, here is Blackhead Chat. Let me just 733 and hit enter. And as you can see, here is Blackhead Chat. Let me just, okay, here is Emersik and here is my password. Here it's all okay, PDB, oh, like that. So as you can see here, here is the waiting room. I have here to wait for 60 seconds, I think, to get in. So here, as you can see, this is Blackhead Chat. Here is the chat, the public chat, and here is the members. There is no staff and there is no admins for now. And actually, you can be a member if you want. And that's it, actually. So let's get started and see how we can create our own chat exactly like this chat. So first things first, we have to launch our Kali machine, and after that we will open our terminal. And here what we have to do is actually launching our MySQL server and Apache server so we can run our chat. Okay, so to do that we have simply, let me just zoom a little bit here, and here I will get sudo access and I'll clear the screen. So here to start Apache and MySQL servers, simply all I have to do is just type systemctl start apache 2 and hit enter. And you have to do the same for MySQL. You have to type systemctl start MySQL and hit enter. And that's it. To check if they actually working, just type systemctl status and type like MySQL. And as you can see here, it's active and running. So just Control C. And here in this video, we're going to use a repository called LeetChat. And this is actually the source code for the chat that we're going to use. LeetChat, you can find it on GitHub. So here you can find the repository and the information about this chat and features and so on. So actually what we're going to do here is just getting that link. And by the way, this link and all the commands I have used, you will find it down in description. So here I will go to var.html and here I will clear my screen and type git clone to clone this chat, and I will paste that link here and give it a couple of seconds and actually will be cloned exactly like that. So I will clear my screen and here I will type cd and get it totally checked. So actually to make this chat running, you have first to create a MySQL database and link this chat with your database. So actually to create your MySQL database, simply what I have to do is type MySQL dash u root and dash b and leave it blank and hit enter exactly like that. So actually I have a command for creating the database. You will find it of course down in description. So here this is my command, and if you just took a look right here, it just here is asking MySQL to create a database called LeetChatDB and creating a user for it. It's called LeetChat user. And here is the password of the database. You can just put whatever you like. And here it's giving it the privileges that it needs. So actually what I'm going to do is just Control C here and get it. And just anything like DB that is T. And let me copy that and paste it here. We will rename the database to chat and the user to chat user, and the password we will just leave it like a password, and here it's going to be the same. So what we have to do right now is open our MySQL and just paste this command one by one. And here we will get this, and like that, it's okay. And this too. And here we will just like that and flush privileges. So here right now we have created our database successfully, just type exit. So what we have to do right now is configure our chat so we can connect with our DB. Here I will just type nano, not nano, let me use something like get chat.php, like that. And here actually what I have to do is just scroll to the bottom of the page. Here you will find the database host and database user and password and database name. So for the host, you will leave it localhost, and the database user, it was a chat user, right? And the password was password, and the database was chat, right? Chat. Like that. And here you have to hit Control S, and here you have to go to your browser and type localhost. So here it gave me the Apache default page because we have our chat in leaf chat php directory. So you can move the files to HTML directory, or you can edit from the Apache configuration, whatever. I'm just showing you how you can do it. So here I will type slash chat and chat.php. Okay, so here's the problem. We have to grant all privileges to chat db mysql-u root-b, and like that. And here I will change this to chat, like that, and exit. And here I'll try to refresh my page. As you can see right here, it's gave me the super admin login. So actually this is the first setup for the chat. So you have to make sure that you save your data. So here I will type it's Amer Sick, and here I will just put my password and the same password again, and I will hit submit like that. And of course, successfully registered. So right now I am the super admin of the chat. So just go to the setup page. Okay, so here is the chat setup. Actually, this is the most important page in the whole chat. So here you can just change the access for the chat, who can access it, only members, or allow with waiting room. You can just allow it for all. And here is the global password, and the global password is a fixed password for the chat, so no one can join the chat without this password. Leave it disabled. So here you can edit whatever you like, but actually the coolest thing here is you can add a custom CSS style and HTML rules and all of that. So just let me here change the font color to red. Yeah, like completely red, exactly like that. And here you can actually do whatever you like here for the, you can find captcha right here, and all these details you will find it here. So just let me apply that and look out. Okay, so here I will look in back after setting up our chat. Okay, as you can see here, here is the admin, it's Emersec, and the staff and members and guests. So actually want to make this admin and staff and members list on the right, like the Black Hat chat exactly. So actually what we have to do right here is go back to our chat directory. Here I will hit Control C and I will ls, and as you can see here, here is the character list on right example.css. I will cut that. I will cut that right here and just take all of that, copy and go right here to admin to set up page, and just let me put this right here. Okay, after that apply and reload messages, and as you can see here it's listed on the right. Okay, so here go to admin and to set up page, and let me change my chat name. It's here my chat, so I will make it Emersick Chat. Okay, and I will apply that, and I'll back to the messages. Let me just try to access this chat from any other machine I have. Let me first get my IP, ifconfig right here. Okay, so and paste it in my browser here. Okay, /chat/chat.php. Okay, as you can see here, I'll type like John, and here is my new password for the new user, and I'll just like choose a color and enter the chat. And as you can see here I can see the admin, it's Emersick, and there is no staff and there is no members, but the guest there is Joe. So here actually if I try to just hit hey and send it, okay, John sent hey. Here you cannot see any admin because John doesn't have any admin privileges. So I will go back to the chat here, and as you can see here there is new guests called John and sent hey. So here actually I can just kick John from here, but I will not do that right now. I'll go to my admin page. So here I will just register John as a member. So here if I choose John and register, here as you can see John is became a member. If I just here exit the chat and then login back. Okay, so as you can see here, John is now registered as a member, and here I'm a member, and actually now I can add public nodes. So here John, you can add it like a regular member or moderator or super moderator or even admin. So I'll just go to filters right here, and let me just here like welcome, and here I will type hey, welcome to our chat, keep it legal and have fun. Okay, so I will just add that, and here if I go to the messages here and type welcome this filter. Okay, so as you can see here, I was checking kick by wrong for user John. Okay, so let me see what John looks like here. Okay, so here you can see that John have been kicked with the message welcome. Okay, so okay, I'll exit the chat right here. So here if I try to use welcome filter and send it, okay, and as you can see here it's hey, welcome to our chat, keep it legal and have fun. And right now you can fully customize this chat to be really your own chat, changing the background, adding logo or whatever, but you can do all from here from the custom CSS, or you can even edit on the source code for the chat, so it's fully customizable. And that's it, you have successfully set up your very own Black Hat chat on the ClearNet. If you want to publish it on the dark web, check out this video here or here. Whether you're hosting it online or locally using them, check out the article link down in description for more details about it. So actually, this is all I got for now. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below, or you can DM me directly using Twitter. Until next time, stay curious and stay secure.